Hello, welcome to your fairy tale wedding show. I am your host, Claudia Chen. Today, we have a very exciting episode for you. We've been talking about destination wedding. And of course, I found someone from the city of love. Here is Reverend Michelle Wahila. She is a pastor who lives in Paris, and she's been marrying couples from all over the world who wants to get married in the city of love in Paris. So welcome, Michelle. How are you?
Oh, thank you so much for having me, and hello from Paris, a cold and kind of wet Paris today.
Oh, no, but I'm sure it's still romantic and beautiful. And I just want to say off the bat, I was actually searching on Instagram looking for an officiant for my show, and Michelle's profile came up, and when I saw her profile, I was like, I have to find a chance to go to Paris to get myself a vow renewed in Paris. So that's how I reached out to her, and she has graciously came on to do a show with us to tell us everything about getting married in Paris. So here we are. Michelle, why don't you give us a little bit background about who you are and how you started actually marrying people in Paris?
Great. Okay. So I'm actually, as you said, I'm a classically trained and ordained pastor. So I come to weddings from maybe a slightly different path than most who work in the industry, but I love that I'm able to share both my passion for writing ceremonies and as well as just like my love for weddings and my love for loves. It really intersects so well. I don't work in the parish anymore. I dedicate all of my time to couples, to marrying them, to telling their love story. So I sometimes feel like I still have one foot in the church and in theology and the things that I love there. And then I have one foot in this wedding industry, which is so cool. And yeah, as you said, I get to marry couples from all over the world in Paris every day. That's my job now. So it's a pretty amazing role. And I know that I'm a really lucky girl.
You are. It is so cool to be doing what you're doing. Other than marrying couples, I know you do vows, renewals. Any other services that you offer?
So actually, I found very rapidly that most folks who are coming to Paris, they don't really know how to navigate the city or to find their other vendors. A lot of times people were finding me and they're like, oh, but we need help. We need help planning. We need help organizing. So it's been a really amazing journey for me, but I have sourced an amazing team of vendors who all really feel just as passionately as I do about what they're doing. And so it's this small, very dedicated core of people, everyone from a driver to a videographer to a florist, you name it, we've sourced it, we can provide it. I even work with a vineyard to provide award-winning champagne for my couples. So I really feel like we've covered all the bases and have gathered this little team together so that when someone comes to me, I can say, yes, we can do that. We can find you the people that you need to make your day as big or as intimate as you want it to be.
That's so awesome. I'm sure there are a lot of people out there who would be interested to actually go to Paris to get married. So would you mind sharing what kind of couples do you usually work with?
Sure. I think one of the most incredible things about my job is truly the diversity of couples that come to me. And I have sort of like two main groups, which is very interesting because I do have this group who come and seek me out because I'm a pastor. They're already planning their wedding in Paris and think like it's going to be easy to just find a pastor to do the ceremony. And it's actually not so easy in Paris to find English-speaking pastors who can do that. So I do have like a very big group of people who are specifically seeking a pastor or spiritual sort of symbolic ceremony or vow renewal. I do a lot of vow renewals for couples who are like wanting them a pastor. And then I have a whole nother group of people who seek me out for various reasons. One, maybe simply because they like the way I talk about love. My Instagram, my social media, like all the places where I speak about love, that platform is so amazing. And then I have folks who have walked away from the church for whatever reason. There's absolutely no judgment on that. But for some reason, they feel a connection with me or want some sort of like ritual or spiritual element that like seems to be right for me, like we're a good match somehow. And then I have folks who come to me specifically because I am inclusive and also a pastor. And that's really important to me. And I want to just, like, I always want to say, proclaim, scream from the mountaintops that I'm inclusive, and I welcome all people who want this blessing, this ceremony in Paris. And then I have folks who, like, they are simply looking for an officiant, and they like whatever they see, whatever I've promoted and put together. And I love those couples too, because I find that maybe we seem like an unlikely match at first, but then what happens is, like, we're actually a perfect match, and I get to honor their love story in whatever creative way they want, and still can be who I am. And it's like, there's no rules, there's no, like, handbook for that, and we just always seem to have this rapport that builds because I take the time to really get to know my clients, which is like an amazing thing that, again, it's just a really special job.
Yeah, it is. And it seems like you work with pretty much everyone. It's because then, like, anyone who are interested, you can search Michelle and come and see what she can do for you. So I know this is a biased question, but why would people want to go to Paris to get married? Isn't it super expensive? Why? What would be some reasons to go get married in Paris?
Well, beyond it being the most romantic city in the world, beyond that, I think people want to come to Paris to get married because it is a place where history and art and food and culture, they all sort of collide to create this atmosphere that is perfect for a wedding or for a vow renewal. But I think it draws adventurous spirits. I mean, it draws people who, like, just want to drop everything and go get married, to elope, or people who have visited the city many times and want that reconnection to this very special place. And also, you mentioned cost, but I think the great thing about Paris, and if it's your dream to get married in Paris or to have a vow renewal in Paris, it is to say that you can do it on any budget. It can be two people and a bouquet and a champagne toast, and it can be just as magnificent as a huge venue filled with florals and a reception afterwards. I think it's making the moment what it is and making the moment yours, which makes it so romantic. And so that means it is for any budget and it is for any number of people. And it means that when our little team works together, we can really tailor it to someone's desires and hopes and dreams for their wedding or vow renewal, which, of course, I love.
Yeah, for sure. Because, like, it's so funny when you talk about elopement, getting married in Paris, the first thing was, it's so different because when people talk about, oh, let's get married in Vegas, and that connotation is so different than when we say, oh, well, let's go and elope in Paris. It's just so much more romantic. You have thought it out, kind of, but it's still fun and adventurous, and it's for real. Not that, like, anyone who got married in Vegas is not for real. It's just so much more romantic because it's Paris.
It draws an adventurous spirit, as does Vegas, but I think it's the history here of the art and the culture and the cuisine and all of those things that sort of merge to create the atmosphere that it is, and that's why it's so special, and that's why, like, everyone should come. And you know what? Come do it.
Yeah. Yeah, for couples who really want to do this, get married in Paris, what are some of the things that they should get ready to prepare themselves to actually make this decision?
I think the most important thing, as in every ceremony, particularly when you're leaving your home country, is to make sure you understand the legalities of it. Mm-hmm. And in France, it's very difficult for foreigners to marry here. And so I always recommend that people just do the paperwork in their home country and come and have their symbolic ceremony here, which is, again, this is a really neat thing because that means there's no rules whatsoever. And we can build the ceremony that people really want. And the legal side of it is taken care of. So that's maybe the most important thing. But second to that, I would say that people need to build a team of vendors that they really trust. And whether or not that's hiring a wedding planner who can then secure everyone else, or finding me, who has this great network, you need to be able to trust your vendors, because when you're planning from afar and you're paying this money and like you're not there and we've never met. I think it's hard for people to say, okay, like, let's do it, let's go for it, if they don't have that trust relationship with at least one of their vendors who they know will like not steer them wrong and can help get the photographer and the videographer and all of the other pieces to fit together nicely, because that's what makes the day, you know, special, when it all runs well, when you have, you know, a great experience with your vendors. Like, that's what we're trying to achieve for people.
And I think it is important that you do trust the people that you hire. Now, if someone's to go to Paris to get married, what is one advice that you would really want to give to them getting married with you?
I tell my couples this quite frequently, but the best piece of advice that I can give to anyone coming to Paris to get married or to have their vow renewal is to come with that adventurous spirit that I talked about, because there are so many unknowns when you're getting married in a destination that's not, say, a resort where you walk to the beach and have your ceremony and walk back to your hotel room. There are things that, you know, could change your day, like maybe it's raining. It rains a lot in Paris, actually. Or we've had some transportation strikes, or someone's plane is delayed and that person is important to you. One of the things I tell my clients is, listen, your day is your day. So I'm there for you from beginning to end, and we'll make it happen. I've had plenty of days where it is pouring rain at ceremony time, and we just step back and say, let's get a cup of coffee or a glass of champagne or both and warm up again, regroup, and sort of then start the day over, because maybe they've had pictures for an hour already. And you don't want wet, grumpy couples, you know, standing before you. They don't want that. And so you do whatever you can to create the day for them. But that means you need to come with the right spirit, to be adventurous, to be flexible, and to go with the flow, to trust your team, to say, let's pause for a coffee and then, you know, and then we'll have our ceremony, instead of looking at the clock and saying, but it's 10 o'clock, because I'm there with you however long we're there. So I think that's the best piece of advice I can give.
Yes, be adventurous and be open-minded is definitely the way to go, just because you have booked that day, and even though you have expected it in your head, something maybe changed, but you have to adjust your mindset so that even if something goes wrong, you still have the best day of your life, right?
Exactly. And that in the end, it's like nothing has gone wrong. It's not wrong. It's just what it has been. It's and like so it creates good. The memory.
It's a little bit different, yeah. All right, so we're almost coming to a close. Michelle, do you have a free gift of something that you would like to give to our viewers?
So I'm going to give to all of our viewers a little checklist for destination weddings and vow renewals, just some things to help people think through how to source vendors and what do they need to think of. And it's maybe not going to apply to every location. It certainly would apply to Paris for anyone who wants to come. But it's a good checklist just for everyone getting married as well. And hopefully, particularly when you're trying to do a destination, that it'll be helpful.
Yeah, that will definitely be very helpful. And thank you so much, Michelle, for coming onto the show with us today. It was such a great time chatting with you. And I love that energy that you have. And I hope that people, after watching your show, will actually make a decision to come to Paris to see you, either getting married there or get their vows renewed in Paris.
Yay, thank you so much. Thank you for having me. And yeah, just blessings upon you.
All right. Bye, Michelle.